long as your questions fall within the acceptable margins of curiosity.
Nah, never mind. So the board is neutral. Okay. So the board isn't necessarily Spacer's choice. The Halcyon Holdings The Halcyon Holdings Board of Directors is a group of CEOs from each of Halcyon's founding companies. Under leadership of Chairman Rockwell, the CEO of Universal Defense Logistics, the board institutes policy and law throughout the Halcyon colony. Hmm. We have these. Neutral. It's too early to tell whether this employee is competent or not. Sublight salvage and shipping. A network of salvagers with business ties to transportation and waste disposal. A tangled web of contractors and secretive vice presidents make up their official hierarchy, leaving no one to speak on the record about Sublight's more legally dubious activities. Monarch Stellar Industries. Once a loyal board-owned corporation, Monarch Stellar Industries split off to become their own private entity under the leadership of Sanjar Nandi. Espousing worker-centric rights and democratic ideals, Sanjar seeks to bring his own band of freedoms to the rest of Halcyon. Iconoclasts. A group of survivalists living in the ruins of Amber Heights on Monarch, led by Graham Bryant, a staunch philosophist, they hope to one day tear down the corporate establishment that they believe has brought the colony to the brink of death. Groundbreaker. Oh. Okay, Groundbreaker. This is information on Groundbreaker. A former colony ship turned space station. Groundbreaker is the only township in the system operating outside the board's control. The Groundbreaker's crew are led by engineer turned Captain Jun Lee Tennyson, and they are fiercely protective of their independence. Okay. So that's where Max, Vicar Max, wants us to go. To hack into their whatever network. The deserters are a community of disillusioned workers who left the town of Edgewater. They live together in a makeshift camp located in a botanical lab district of Emerald Vale. Not anymore, they don't. Spacer's Choice is the favorite brand for colonists on the budget. The town of Edgewater and the region of Emerald Vale are properties of the Spacer's Choice Company. So Spacer's Choice is revering, so that doesn't have to do with the board. The Halcyon board is not part of it, apparently. My charm is high. I like that. Cool. Well.
I've been feeling pretty low these days.
Don't let the boss catch you saying that.
Hmm. Where are we headed?
Oh, so she mentioned something.
You mean why I'm not allowed in the store anymore?
Oh, yeah. There seems to be a story there.
There was a kind of a thing with a vending machine when I was 12.
You're a kid. That must have been forever ago.
Sure, but folks got long memories around here. I've always been good with my hands, right? So I saw a lock on the machine and thought, oh, this must be how they refill it. But I had to know. So I did my thing. And next thing I know, there's a couple hundred bottles of Zero G rolling out the front door and into the road.
I'm gonna laugh.
It's not funny. Right about then, a bunch of loaders came rolling in the gate, fresh off the Saltuna ships. And Mr. Thompson was up on the porch making a speech about how everyone would have to volunteer a third shift to get it all canned. Anyhow, you ever seen an auto loader run over a bottle of Zero G?
Go on.
Exploded all over Mr. Thompson.
Boosh.
One bottle after another as the loaders went by.
Oh my.
I was just shy of working age, so Dad had to pay all the damages. Ro's still angry at me. I can laugh about it now, but I just about puked up my guts in terror in the moment. That's the one time I ever made Mr. Thompson look a fool.
Okay. Anything new with you, sir?
I could spend hours reflecting on the secret workings of the universe.
Oh, yeah?
Little else in this colony offers such a relaxing pastime. So, tell me what's on your mind. I excel at confessional listening.
Nothing at this point. I wonder if these machines have restocked yet. Let's go take a quick look. Because we go through heavy ammo like you wouldn't believe. Nice. Didn't I take that perk? Maybe it reset before I applied the perk. Maybe next time it gets stuff, we'll have more. And where's the other one? Through here and then downstairs, I think? Or we are downstairs. I know every time I'm buying light armor, even though I haven't used it. Additional stock on vendors. But it's still times 50. It says it here, too. Is it because it restocks? Normally it would be 25 because it restocked them all? I don't know. Oh, you know what? I have stuff, right? Yeah. I'm gonna keep the rest. Oh, there's another trip blade though. And a hunting rifle when I have one already. Alright. That's good. See if these restocked as well. Because there's a lot of them here. Maybe it just changes the price? I don't even know. It's times 50. I'm pretty sure it was times 50 already. Ooh. Look at that. That's new. A shock cannon? A heavy weapon built to hit nearby enemies with arcing electricity. The weapon locks on to a non-friendly target within range, firing a continuous stream of electricity. That's pretty sweet. It takes energy. And what do I use? It's less, it's just, I don't know. It might be useful to certain kinds of enemies, like the auto-mechanicals, probably. The shock cannon uses TNL's proprietary lock and shock technology to make sure you never waste a single watt. It's pretty sweet looking. It's expensive, though. Oh, now they're selling armor. Yeah, that's the kind that I don't like because it brings down stealth skills. But I assume all heavy armor would bring down stealth skills? Deadeye Assault Rifle. Exacto Sight. Hammersmith originally tried to sell this gun with the slogan Sniper's Choice, but they were sued by a company that they're legally not allowed to identify. I wonder who that would be. 198 though. Deadeye Assault Rifle. Special Effect Execute. And has Exacto Sight. Magazine 2 and post armor damage dealt plus 15%. Compare? Am I comparing with Well, the thing is, can I compare with something I have equipped? Because it's not going to show up here. Oh, it turned off now. Wait. It's better than the light assault rifle. Oh, the damage, yeah, a lot better. The only thing, though, is it's, you're switching magazines. Really, a lot more. A lot more. Six. Six rounds in each. You won't have to change it as quickly because it's doing a lot more damage. I'll buy it. Let's buy some more stuff here. Ammo. We have a lot of light ammo now. Alright. Well, this thing's damaged anyway. Now this thing has mods on it already. Does this mean that I can add more mods on top of it, or would that remove the mods that are already on it? So I'm saying, are they bonus mods that are just permanently on there? If that's the case,
heard something outside the walls today.
This way.
Nothing. Wish we had some better rations.
So you can only use these. Changes to plasma. Changes to shock. We got these. Extendo sight. So we already have that. And gyro sight. Huh, you're really limited with the mods on this. If you install the modification to this slot, the current one will be destroyed. Okay, meaning we're gonna take out. We're gonna destroy the exacto site, and I don't want that. What about with the plasma? What about the grenade launcher, actually? Increases critical damage dealt, plus 25%. And then this is. This changes to plasma and shock. Is that a good thing? I don't know if that's necessarily an improvement, or maybe against certain enemies. This is definitely worth it. Yeah, give it a try. Okay. Oh, we need to repair this. So I think I'll sell the other one. Is it? Oh. Give me the good one. I'm gonna repair this just in case we're out where we can't repair stuff and someone needs some armor. Does it take? Oh, I use up almost all my armor parts. So what's the difference between tinkering and modifying? Oh, can increase the damage a little bit? This one says damage 99. But it already is so. Or is it just showing me what it would be after I tinker with it? It's already 99. Oh, damage goes up to 108. I see. I guess it's showing me the old damage plus that. That's sweet. Awesome. So let's get magazine 2. That's all we can change, okay, so not changing that. Cool. Really have much else to do unless those quests we find just by wandering around the world here. I mean, I'm pretty sure we have not been all over here. We have, and we can't get up there, whatever that is, but I'm pretty sure we've not been to the limits. I don't know if you can even get up there because these look like mountain ranges. It gets higher and higher. Or does it get lower? Not sure. In any case, let's head back to the landing site. I'm pretty happy with everything we've done with our weapons. Pretty sweet. You know, we could also do is improve their weapons. Probably be worth it to do that.
Is this your ship? Oh my star, she is just so handsome. Does she have a name yet? What's her drive model?
Unreliable.
Listen to me babbling. When I was in Edgewater, I dreamed of flying on a real ship, working on a real engine, belonging to a proper crew.
What?
I'm the only decent mechanic Edgewater's got, but every time I think of going back, I get this sinking feeling.
Well, I'm not sure about a proper crew, but I can fulfill your other wishes. So you've never been on a ship before?
I've worked on the occasional supply coach in need of repairs. Once I built a little model craft out of spare parts, but Mr. Thompson found out and I had to take it apart. I want to ask you something, and you can say no. But can I come with you?
Yes.
I could tend to your engine. I know my G-valves from my catalyzers, and I can keep your ship singing.
Oh.
And if you ever need a pair of eyes watching your back, I can do that too. What do you think?
She knows where the G-valve is. I'll be glad to have you along. Pick a cabin and it's yours.
Yes! I mean, thanks. You won't regret this, ma'am.
I don't think I would.
Captain. I can call you Captain now. I got a captain.
I love it.
Where are we headed?
On the ship.
By verity, by strength. What are we contemplating today?
Nothing. It's been a while since we've been here.
Something you need?
Captain, I have detected that Edgewater's power supply is now optimal. I applaud your willingness to invest your time in the local community.
Oh, thank you.
What can I do for you, Captain?
I have a power regulator.
Do you know how to install a power regulator?
Yeah, I know what I'm doing.
Outstanding, Captain. Your aptitude for engineering will prove invaluable in the event of another catastrophic engine failure. Our engine room is located behind you, across the cargo bay, up the ladders.
Okay, I'll be back. We got power.
Something you need?
Nice. Hawthorne, oh yeah. Now that the power regulator is installed, speak with Ada to pilot the Unreliable out of Emerald Vale. Sweet. I wonder if we get to look around cabins now, if these people actually have cabins. Vocational competence. Oh, respec. Nope. I'm happy with my skills the way they are. Can I just jump down? Didn't even hurt me. And they just appeared down here somehow. Oh. I don't know why that happens. Hold on. Yeah, that's the second time that happened. Captain's... Why are my own quarters sealed? Yeah, you guys probably couldn't even tell, but my whole display just went black for a little bit. So maybe I have to take off first for any of these cabins to actually belong to anybody. That's the captain's quarters, I think.
What can I do for you, Captain?
I've installed the power regulator.
All systems are operating within acceptable parameters.
Sweet.
I am prepared to bring the Unreliable into low altitude orbit. This should prove an adequate test of our flight capabilities.
Hold on, I need to take care of something. I know this is a bit anticlimactic, but I'm just wondering if what's her name, Adelaide, is now... if she's finally up in Tobson's office. Because somebody said, I think it was a general store guy, he said things have improved.
Almost lost a finger in the counter.
At least you've got your health. For all I know, he's still here. Come on, guys, you ain't getting into this? Nope, he's still here.
I already told you I'm leaving. Just get...
Yeah. No music this time. What's in the codex? Quest dependencies. Let's do this.
Welcome back, Captain. All systems are now operating within acceptable parameters. Shall I take our ship into orbit?
Yes. Let's get out of here.